Good morning. I am Captain S.S. Panesar, former Director of Flight Safety and Training from Indian Airlines, and I'm also on deputation to the DGCA, Director General Civil Aviation, as a Senior Flight Inspector for almost 2.5 years. Today, we will discuss about the scene of aviation in India and the role of this regulatory body, that is the Director General of Civil Aviation. Government in the past have appointed very high-level committees. One was under the chairmanship of Aviation Advisor Air Marshal Keeler. Another committee was formed by government under the chairmanship of Air Marshal J.K. Seth. PVSM, Ati Vishesh Seva Medal, and P.C. Sen, Mr. R. Chatterjee, and Mr. Khola, the Director General of Civil Aviation at that time. To go through the role of the DGCA. The major role of DGCA is to make rules and regulations as per the Indian Aircraft Rules, Indian Aircraft Act, and also to conduct examinations for the issue of flying crew license and license for the AMEs, flight dispatcher, as per the law of the land. But it was seen that the Department of Air Safety, DGCA, which is comprising of officers having no knowledge of the high-tech aircraft, that is Boeing 747-400, A320, A300, 310, A320, Boeing 737, etc. And these committees recommended many things after there were a lot of protests by the aviation expert to segregate the investigation from DGCA to a separate body. The government did comply to this and they formed a separate board by the name Aircraft Accident and Investigation Board, which is being headed by a very high-tech officer, Group Captain Handa. Is a very intelligent, very honest, very fair, very knowledgeable also. The investigation accidents is a very, very important activity in determining the corrective measures necessary for minimizing the existence of hazards in aviation safety. It is essential that such persons or experts who are going to investigate the accident should have undergone formal training in accident investigation, and they should also possess analytical skills, perseverance, and maturity. Now, what happens in the recent cases of Calicut crash, the committee is formed, which is again from the people from DGCA. And the chairman of the committee is going to investigate the accident. I don't think he has ever done any investigation or any training in investigation of accident. To me, it seems to be just a cover-up operation. The past committees, which are headed by Air Marshal Seth, he has given in his report that the present system of investigating incident accident by the untrained officers of the DGCA is very bad at demoralizing. In DGCA, one man is appointed to conduct the investigation incident. He makes the report and he gives a judgment also. The same person is the jury and the same person is the judge. This system breeds corruption. Also, and it does not help in improving the operational safety or the standard of aviation. Nowhere in the world any regulatory body does investigation or incident. There are separate boards, which of course the government of India has made a separate board. Now, going through this accident at Calicut, we find the pilot from Dubai who was coming, he made one attempt to land And before a pilot, in fact, starts his descent to land at an airport, he is apprised of the latest weather at the landing airport. He also gets the weather of the diversionary airports, status of the airport, runway conditions, so many things he is given before he commences descent. After that, the pilot decides to land at that airport and he commences descent for landing. Now this pilot, while landing in Calicut, he found the weather was quite bad, low cloud, rain. But however, he made one approach. During the approach, he must have assessed the weather, but when he is coming into land, he was not comfortable with the weather and the conditions, so he carried out a missed approach. When he carried out a missed approach, the normal thing is when a pilot has seen the weather himself and he could not land, he normally decides to go around to an alternate airport. But in this case, the pilot was insisting to come and land again at this airport. And in the second approach, probably he landed with a little high speed and landed after almost 3,200 feet of leaving runway. And when he found that the runway is wet and slippery, the brakes are not effective, probably he has tried to carry out a missed approach again. But since the runway is very short and being a tabletop, he just went in the valley. Because he went in the valley with the probably speed, the cockpit was crushed very badly into the debris. And I feel the pilots have died immediately after the crash. Now, in such an incident, it is the duty of the aerodrome officer to immediately lock down the area with the help of the police and all that, so that no unwanted people run around near the aircraft, call for the emergency help and all the airport emergency services. But if it happens beyond the area of the aerodrome, he is supposed to consult immediately the district magistrate, who will provide all the help in the evacuation of the passengers, help the injured person or their dead bodies to be taken out and all that. This was the normal procedure laid down by the International Civil Aviation Organization. And now, we have seen some videos in which we find after everybody is evacuated, even the injured person are taken out, the bodies are taken out, we find almost after 4 hours, two people are entering the cockpit and they're searching something. Very shocking. We don't know who allowed them, who were those persons. I don't know, only the inquiry, and they will find it out. Because people in Calicut or elsewhere, they are only apprehending that they must be either some gold being smuggled, they are searching for the gold in the cockpit or somewhere. That is, of course, the inquiry will come out, or if they appoint a CBI inquiry, they may be able to find it out. What is the purpose of those people entering in the cockpit? Now, this incident, this committee which has been formed, none of them has experience and training of investigation of accident. To me, it seems they're just a cover-up operation. And I may tell you also that in the past, many accidents, fatal accidents also took place, in which the government immediately appointed a judicial inquiry. In this case, where more than 20 people have died, I don't know what are the hesitation with the government having to appoint a judicial inquiry and let the public know what is the cause, exact reason for the crash of this flight. In the public inquiry, the public will be advised of the tape transcript of the cockpit voice recorder, digital flight data recorder, and aircraft talks with the control tower. But nothing will be made public in this inquiry. I find the system of inquiry is so complicated and all that, I don't know for reasons known. One incident took place in Trichy. For the last 2 years, the Director General of Civil Aviation immediately suspended the license of those two pilots for 3 years without having any inquiry report, without any justification, without any reasons for putting them out of the flying. Those two young boys, they are just trolling around to find out what to do. Why the DGCA and the Air Cargo Investigation Board for last almost going to be 2 years to that incident could not find the reasons of that crash and give a report is a minor incident. And now, of course, they said that this crash in Calicut will give the report within 5 months, which I doubt very much we'll be able to get this report in 5 months. I am of the strong opinion, as per the in report, even the Air Marshal Seth report, he said the aspect of investigation procedure which needs to be reformed, that is the power of the DGCA to suspend pilots, engineers, air traffic controllers for long, indefinite periods, pending the completion of investigation. In many such cases, the eventual punishment turns out to be virtually the regularization suspension already inflicted pending investigation. Is that the way? Who's going to pay the young pilots for 3 years of suspension? And suppose it may not be any fault of the pilots. We don't know the reason for which they have suspended the license. This is the shocking state of affairs, and we must take some, government should take measures and all that to expedite such investigation. Even the International Civil Aviation Organization has laid down the time period for such investigation, but I don't know whether we follow that or not, although we are a party to the ECAO system of investigation. In this crash at Calicut, very sad incident, it required definitely a judicial inquiry, because there are so many factors involved. Why pilots are insisting to land again at Calicut, knowing very well the weather is very bad, and he could not land in first attempt. He should have immediately diverted to some other safer place like Trivandrum, Cochin, or Bangalore, which are well within his limits. All these factors will come out in the inquiry, and we have to wait till the inquiry comes and their recommendation, and to improve the safety of our traveling passengers in India, Indian traveling and aviation, for their safe travel and all that. I wish that we will be able to improve our safety system and bring much more safety measures so that such incidents do not occur in future. I don't have to say anything more than this. I only pray we have some experts. I have also come to know the Government of India has invited NTSB to help the investigation board. It is a very good idea, because NTSB is very expert, but they do not involve any regulatory function, a federal aviation in investigation of incident. They give an independent inquiry. Independent investigation is done. Here we are dependent on so many people, maybe some political reason, other reason. You do not know why he was again and again insisting to land only at Calicut. Were there any contrabands kept on board? Was he aware of those things? It's only a matter of investigation. Let's pray to God that aviation in India will improve. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.